What up YouTube, Evil Snape here, bringing you some Titanfall gameplay, playing some hardpoint domination, using the Hemlock, the three burst gun. Normally I use the RC-101 carbine, but I'm changing it up a little bit. And while we're on the subject of Titanfall, I just want to say that my Road to Final Gen series is still going along, and we'll be coming back with commentary. I know a lot of people have been calling for more commentary episodes, so I'll be bringing them back, and so look forward to that. Anyway, moving on to the subject of the video, and that is a little game called Destiny is causing a lot of butthurt amongst the gaming community. Mostly, the butthurt, I guess, comes from the Microsoft side, because Sony fans are sitting pretty with this one. For those of you that have been living under a rock, Destiny is, I don't know, how to explain it. It's a first-person shooter, RPG, MMO. It's going to be a massive game, and the reason why, there's a couple of reasons why Xbox fans are a little bit butthurt, and I guess sort of rightfully so, maybe kind of, I don't know, I'm just talking out loud, thinking out loud rather, obviously I'm talking out loud, but the couple of reasons why Xbox fans are pissed off is because Destiny is being made by Bungie, and they are the guys that started Halo. And that is Microsoft's, you know, pride and joy. And again, rightfully so. It's a great game. It's a great series, and still going strong. They have been working with Microsoft for a while, and now they're doing something different. And it's part B of why Xbox fans are pissed off is because Sony, the PlayStation, is getting a shitload of exclusives, and not just like a month before like Call of Duty or whatever, but like a year before. So, you know, people are going to be a little bit pissed off about that. And is it justified? I don't know. I guess you can be a little bit annoyed about it, but at the end of the day, I think you just got to, you know, chin up, princess, and get on with it. And this is all coming from Microsoft fan. Like, I'm not a fanboy. I predominantly play on Xbox. I'm getting a PlayStation 4 basically when they get better bundles. That's all that's stopping me, is I just don't want to get pay a lot for a console and then just have to pay for a shitload of games. But anyway, back onto the topic. And, you know, it's a little bit silly. And then, of course, there's with the whole resolution gate. Now that Kinect has been dropped from the Xbox One, it is now being able to get 1080 at 30, I'm pretty sure, which is the same as PlayStation, if I'm not mistaken, which is good. It's good to see that they were able to get to buff it up to be equal with the PlayStation. Hopefully other game developers can utilize that a little bit extra and really buff the games out, especially with a lot of games being pushed back into 2015. I think that it could be pretty beneficial. But this game, Destiny, I'm not even sure if I am. Well, I was not. I haven't been excited for the game up until, I don't know, I guess a few weeks ago. I've just been trying to kind of avoid it because it's just been so massively hyped, and this whole shitstorm with, you know, the PlayStation versus Xbox thing. I don't really like to step in and put my head into all these console wars. And that's another thing, I guess, I'll touch on that as well while I am talking about it. Console wars, are they good for the gaming industry? I think they are, as long as the fans don't get too obnoxious and get caught up all in it all. I mean, obviously, if you, these people that battle that one console is better than the other, it's like a gang war. I mean, calm down. You don't have to live or die by your console. You're not blood in, blood out, and it's sometimes just gets really ridiculous. And it reminds me a little bit of like really over-the-top wrestling fans that are just so in-depth in it, and they can't just see what it's all about, and what it's about with gaming is just that there needs to be some sort of fighting force in the fan base to obviously push each Microsoft and Sony, to make them push and do their best, and to not let one slack and get the other one over them, because it's all about sales. They want to make as much money as they can, and as a business, that's obviously the goal. But as long as the fans realize that we are the ones that need to play them, we are the gamers, we need to make this work in our favor. So at the end of the day, what I really think about all these exclusives and stuff like that, yeah, you can get pissed off about Bungie, if you want to go so dramatic to say that they're deserting Xbox fans. You can be pissed off about the exclusives not coming to the Xbox for a year. But at the end of the day, Xbox players aren't playing against PlayStation players, so it doesn't really matter what kind of weapons or anything that they have before us, because we're not taking them on one by one, and it's still going to be a level playing field basically on your console. So I just sit back and I watch all these little kids and people who aren't little kids act like little kids about gaming. These are things that we're supposed to be doing for entertainment and to take our mind off stupid shit, and yet people want to draw it in and make it about what? I really just don't see the point in it, unless you're using it in your favor to make these gaming companies really push it and not slack. But I don't think a lot of these little kids just chirping off in the mouth, recycling facts that they've heard from other people to try and seem like the bigger nerd out of their friends, and there's better ways to do that. Like I said, make sure that we are the ones that are in control, because we're the gamers, we are the ones that need to be doing the playing, not being played by game companies. Some of the console war discussions, and I use that term loosely, are just downright they're just so embarrassing, and they make me not want to associate myself with gamers. I'm just someone that plays video games, I guess, at this point. Because if a gamer is someone that chirps off of the mouth and, goes on gaming forums and websites like IGN and GameSpot and stuff like that just to completely rag and shit on a game that's either coming out on your console or not coming out on your console, it's just ridiculous. Come on, gaming community, we need to do better than this. Making yourselves look like idiots. And basically what I've been doing in this game, making them look like idiots, because I've not quite sure, but I've gone on a massive streak, and I think my end life is like 12-1 as we get the victory. And head over to the evac points and shut them down. My final thoughts, I guess, on the whole subject is Destiny is no doubt going to be a massive game. I don't think we need to do any more fighting to try and make them do the best with that. It's pretty much going to be set in stone. I'm looking forward to playing the beta, at least, to get a little bit more excited about it. I'm probably going to end up getting it, but I don't think I'll go to any extreme and get a collector's edition or anything like that. And if you're worried about what gaming console you should get it on, if you're lucky enough to have both consoles, get it whatever your friends are going to get it on, because this is a multiplayer game, so if you're not playing with your friends, then I don't know what you're doing, unless you like playing with a bunch of randoms, which is nothing wrong with that. In closing, don't let the gaming industry play us. We need to play them. We are the gamers. Let's be smarter than this. All right. Whoop, whoop. There we are. 12-1. I am Evil Snave, and I will kill you later. If you enjoyed that, please hit the like button and be sure to share with your friends. And if you want to see more, then make sure you have annotations turned on and hit the thumbnail. Or, for a different type of video, hit one of the other thumbnails. Or you can hit my avatar to head over to my channel for many more videos and be sure to subscribe while you're there. Also, check the description for links to my Facebook and Twitter and eStore where you can buy shirts and hoodies. I'm Evil Snave, and I'll kill you.